teach you about leaf or tips and group, I'm sure you'll know about it already. If there's somebody who's come to this, exhibition wanting to talk about how to do leaf, then someone's going to teach you at some point during the day. But what I'm going to do is start off by telling you a story. And this is a fairly common story amongst a lot of organisations, small to medium-sized businesses, or family run. And basically, we're looking at family run manufacturing business, been around for 50 years, high quality product reputation. Okay, it's been built up over a long period of time, and original staff of the company was now getting to the stage where he wants to move on. Okay. He wants to hand it over to the next generation. So, approximately, there's a few things that are happening in the background. First of all, the first generation has got to get tired, they want to get out, can't quite get their heads around some of these beautiful things that come in. What does social media affect? Okay. Well, I've got to be on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, all those sorts of things. That's great for the young people to talk to each other, but why is it affecting my business? Okay. But they realise they're now ready to hand over to the next generation. Okay. So, what about that next generation? They understand all these new techniques, they understand why these things are doing so much better for them, why they've got to be on the bandwagon than everybody else is doing. And they realise that they are important things for today's business. They just don't quite understand how the first generation can't quite get their head around this sort of thing, grasp these opportunities. But they can see they desperately need to get the company back to its former levels of profitability. Okay. So, there's some internal conclusions to this. That they need to change business processes, modernise their IT. They need to be able to sell more. They need to be able to drive down costs as well. So they're just selling more if you don't get the costs down where they should be as well. So in short, we're looking about lean productivity, continuous improvement. Yes, there is a reason for this. Okay, this is why I'm comprehensive, of course. Lots and lots of stuff could go on a slide like this. Basically, we're looking at old processes going to new processes. So, in the old way, mixed market is a silo. Everyone's doing their own little job. It started off 50 years ago with paper, then it went to oil spreadsheets. But at the end of the day, most people are using spreadsheets a lot these days just as electronic versus a paper. Mistakes made in one place, they don't learn the lessons across the organisation. Okay? So lots of mistakes get repeated. However, coming to a new world where you can have an integrated system to make sure that all the processes of your business are working together. So, some processes get done automatically. It says there, practices are all the automation these days. There was quite a lot of people doing it. 20 years ago, nearly everybody was doing it. Okay? Some processes eliminated. Helping sales orders to distribute across all of the departments. It just doesn't happen these days. Okay? All processes being computerized. However, being really slick, being quicker than how you were before is all really well, but actually, you need to work out sometimes. You don't want to do things quicker, you just want to stop doing them. No good doing the process twice as fast. Actually, you shouldn't have the process in the first place. Okay, back to our little story. First generation, second generation others. Let's be fair, first generation are loved. Okay? They know things need to change. 20 years ago, they actually brought in some computers, mini computers. So, that was okay for 20 years ago. generation, they know that they need to change today. Okay? Business moves too fast today for us to make one change, sit on a lot of idols and ears, and then make another one. Amazing number of new ideas and things coming up, and they're all being funded, invested in by lots and lots of organisations. So, processes, they need to be standardised, authorised, the best way to do this for R&D organisations. They come in many colours, shapes and sizes. And many of them are marketed by installing the virtues of best practice. However, most of these systems have been around for 20 years, 30 years. Now, what were best practice back then? What are the chances that it's still best practice now? Probably very low. Okay? So, from our earlier observations, build your business processes to behave in a flexible manner. We want all of our businesses to work in a flexible manner. You must have a system, an ERP solution, that is working in a flexible manner as well. If you want the benefits of continuous improvement, your ERP solution must be capable of being changed using your system. Okay, just a few little examples, and I'll finish up, of some of the friends that we've got. So, they make lots and lots of school uniforms. They've been doing it for donkey's years, back in the 19th century. Okay? Many, many years ago, yes, they sourced all of their material in the UK. It was made in the cloth mills around Manchester. Okay? Clothing was completely manufactured in the UK. Then they had a little change. Material was sourced in the Far East, out of Bangladesh. Clothing was still manufactured in the UK. Okay? A little bit later, both the material and the manufacturers are out in Bangladesh. But the specialist badges that each individual school needs on their sweatshirts and their blazers, is actually still being done in the UK. Now, everything goes wrong. Okay? Now, in order to achieve all of those changes, you cannot have a single system that doesn't change really. Many of our customers are project-oriented customers. Okay? Now in their business process, they've got some really big challenges. They design their product by project. They manufacture the items within the project, usually by batch, and then they deliver their projects to their customers on project together. Okay? So consequently, you've got to really change around the way things are happening within the organization. For that, we've got to have flexibility. Anything to do with the living product. So we've got customers like butters, coffee pullets, who actually grow chickens. Anyone who has a bunch of chicks, then you've already been able to handle some of the very unique challenges that are important. Okay, the last one is GSM Automotive. Who would have thought Stan Bain stands for a manufacturing organisation in the automotive industry? But they need some very flexible aspects of their system as well. They need the system to stop them making anything when something goes wrong. It needs alerts, warnings. But they need to have the flexibility to know when those alerts and warnings are going to be required. So, conclusion. Well, not enough. First of all, your ERP system does not operate in vacuum. It's got to be part of your operation. You must have the capability to change, and to change continuously. To save your cash reserves, such changes must be easy to do. Those don't have the system that you've got to get an outside IT company in to change every time you want a little tweak. Then you need to be able to do it yourself. Save your sanity and your cash reserves. Changes must work in your future upgrades. So what you do today has got to work with the software. There is, let's face it, no perfect business process. Every single business process in every single company is different. Okay? And continuous improvement, as I'm sure everybody must know, should be exactly that, continuous. Okay? Don't make changes one at a time over a long period of time. You should be making those changes enjoy the rest of your day, everybody. If you want to come and talk any more, thanks.